Welcome. The topic we'll be discussing in this lecture is storage management. So, as a resource manager, operating system also performs storage management. So, here storage in the sense we refer to secondary storage devices like hard disks and tapes. Okay, so this topic we'll be discussing under four headings. The first topic we'll be discussing under storage management is file system management, followed by that we'll be discussing mass storage management, then we'll be discussing caching, that is cache memory, which we have already discussed to some extent. And then we will be discussing I/O system. So storage management we'll be discussing under four headings: file system management, mass storage management, caching, and I/O system. So we'll start with file system management. Okay. So before proceeding, let us try to define file. What is a file? Okay. So you might be using this word file under different context. For example, say I have a C file, I have a Java file, I have a Word file, I have a Notepad file. All these are files. But how do we define file? What is a file? A file is a collection of related information. A file is a collection of related information. If you take a Java file, it will have Java statements. If you take a C file, it will have C statements. Okay. Like that. Or if you are writing a letter to someone through Word or Notepad, so that is also related information. Okay. So basically a file is a collection of related information. Okay. And files can be of free form or strictly formatted. Free form in the sense there is no particular formatting, but anywhere a string may occur, somewhere an integer may occur, at some other place some special character may occur. There is no specific restriction like here you have to type only integer, here you have to type only character, here you have to type only strings. If there is no such restrictions, such files are called as free form, whereas there are files which are strictly formatted. It, in the sense that you specify a strict format, like in this place or in this column it should be only string, and here it should be only integer, here it should be only some special characters. So like that, there are different types of files available. Okay, so these are some of the definition of file. But basically, what is a file? What we call it as a file, as we have discussed in one of the previous lecture, a file is a logical resource. A file is a logical resource. It is not a physical resource. It is, you cannot physically see a file. So it is a logical resource. So basically files are where it is stored. Files are stored in hard disk. And what hard disk contains? Hard disk contains tracks and sectors. Okay. Assume that there is no concept like file. Then how will you refer to the content that is stored in the hard disk? Then there is only one way to refer. We have to say that the content, whatever you have given, it is stored from track 1, sector 1 to track 10, sector 5. But if user gets such information, user will not be comfortable with that information. User will not be comfortable with that information. So basically, a file, what is a file? A file is a logical view of information that is stored in the disk. Okay. File is a logical view of the information that is stored in the disk. So it is not the real view, it is a logical view. Why we provide this logical view? Because user is convenient with this logical view than the real view. Because real view, in the sense you have to say that it is stored in this particular track, in this particular sector, starting from this track, this sector, to ending at this track, that sector. That end user may not appreciate that. Okay, so in that context, file is a logical view of the information storage. So basically, the file abstract the physical properties. The file abstracts from the physical properties of storage devices and provide a logical storage unit for the convenience of users. Okay, so this is how we technically define a file, right? Okay, so what is the definition of file? The operating system abstracts from the physical properties of the storage devices and provide a logical storage unit. This logical storage unit is called as files. Okay, so I hope you understand what is a file. So file is a logical view. It is not physical. Physically, actually, it is residing in the hard disk, and this logical view, it's provided for user convenience. So basically, the operating system abstracts from the physical properties of the storage devices and provides a logical storage unit. This logical storage unit is called as file. Why operating system provides this logical storage unit? It just for user convenience. Okay. So this is how we define file. And files are managed by operating system. And how it manages? It manages by using various secondary storage devices like magnetic disk, optical disk, tapes. Using such things, the files are managed by an operating system. Okay. As a part of file management, these are the typical activities an operating system can perform. And one more thing about file is, files can be further organized into directories. Okay, you know what is a directory? A directory is otherwise called as a folder. A folder can have multiple files. So again, directory is also a logical view, or it's a logical storage unit. In reality, everything is in the disk. Okay, so as a part of storage management, as a part of file system management, the operating system can perform the following tasks. It can create or delete files and directories. Okay, it can include primitives to manipulate files and directories. Manipulate means what? Manipulate means reading content from a file, writing content to a file, or appending content to the file. So that is called as manipulation. It can modify or whatever it may be. It can write. Okay, mapping files onto storage, secondary storage. Okay, so because file is a logical entity, it is not the real entity. So every file should be mapped somewhere to some space in the physical storage device. So actually, if you have a file here, then it should be mapped into the hard disk at some location, at some tracks and sector. So this mapping is hidden from the user. User does not know how it is mapped, but operating system should deal with this mapping, so that we say that the operating system abstracts the physical properties of the storage devices and provides a logical storage unit. Okay. So this mapping file to the secondary storage device should be done by the operating system. Okay. And also the operating system backs up files on non-volatile storage media. Okay. Some important files need to be backed up. So in that case, operating system will back up in the hard disk itself is non-volatile. Okay. Maybe in some part of the hard disk, it may keep it may back up the content. Okay, so this is about file system management. Okay, so storage management we'll be discussing under four headings: file system management, MOS storage management, caching, and IO system. So the next thing that we'll be discussing is MOS storage management. So what is meant by MOS storage? So MOS storage includes disks and tapes. It includes magnetic disks, and also it includes magnetic tapes. So disks are very much important. Disks and tapes, or MOS storage unit, is very much important in a computer system, because main memory is volatile in nature. That is, the content in the main memory will be available only as long as the power is available. If the power is removed, if the power is not available, then the content in the main memory will be deleted. So to permanently store the data, we need mass storage devices like disks and tapes. Okay, so these mass storage devices also is maintained by the operating system. Okay, and the speed of these mass storage devices will also affect the performance of the operating system. Okay, if the mass storage devices works at a greater speed, obviously it will increase the system performance. If it works at a lesser speed, then in turn it will affect the system performance. See, maybe you may have a very high speed processor, but the disk that you are using, if it is very slow, then the processor has to wait for every IO operation. Then the overall functionality of the computer in terms of speed, it will be very slow. Okay, so as a part of mass storage management, operating system performs these tasks: free space management. That is, the disks and tapes may have free spaces. So how to utilize this free space, or what it will do? It will collect all the free spaces and it will keep it in one particular location. Okay, that is, say for example, just for understanding purpose, I'm saying, say this is your disk, and here some data is available, or here some data is available. Okay, so I'm representing if data is available with this. So these are the place where data is available, but in between there is no data. So these are free spaces, but this is not an effective management of free space. So in that case, what the operating system will do, in the sense, operating system will move all the non-free content at one end, and all the free content at another end. So these locations are already occupied with some files. So this will be kept together, okay? And all the empty spaces will be collected together, so that if some new file comes, it can be allocated space. Okay, so this is called as free space management. So this free space management, how to effectively utilize the free spaces, that will be done by operating system. And storage allocation, when a new file comes in, that is, if the CPU or the operating system wants to store some new file to the disk or tape, then where it should be stored? It should be stored here, or it should be stored here, or if recently some file is deleted, then it can be stored here. So this decision will be taken by operating system. So it is called as so the storage allocation, basically it will be decided by the operating system. Okay, and next what we have is called as disk scheduling. Okay, what is meant by disk scheduling? Disk scheduling means when there are multiple processes residing in the main memory, more than one process may want to access the disk simultaneously. Okay, so assume that three processes were residing in the main memory at a given time. Okay, so there are three processes residing in the main memory, P1, P2 and P3. So all these three processes want to access the memory at the same time. Okay, then who should be given access first? Not main memory, disk. Okay, all these three processes want to access the disk or disk at the same time. So who should be given access first? So the request comes at the same time, but you cannot give everybody simultaneous access, because you have only one hard disk controller. It can handle only one request at a time. So maybe based on some priority, the operating system will decide whether P1 should be given access, or P2 should be given access, or P3 should be given access. So this decision will be taken by operating system. Okay, so this is called as disk scheduling. Okay, so previously we discussed that the disk should be working at a faster speed, so that it will also help the computer to ensure effective performance. But in some cases, the mass storage device need not be fast, still it can be used. Okay, for example, there are tertiary storage devices. Say these CDs, optical discs, or magnetic tapes can also be called as tertiary storage. It is the next level of secondary storage. Okay, so they are generally used as backup devices. So it is not required that they need to be fast. Even if they are slow, it's not an issue because they are not in the mainstream of process execution. Okay, so who will be managing these tertiary storage devices? In some cases, it will be managed by operating system, and in some cases, it will be managed by some specific applications. Okay, and there are different types of tertiary storage devices available, like VOM. VOM means write once, read many times. That is, you can write only once. Once it is written, you cannot rewrite it. Okay, but you can read it any number of time. And there are also other types of tertiary storage devices available, like read-write disk. That is, you can read and then erase, and you can write. For example, if you take CD, there are two types of CDs. There is CD-ROM and also CD-RW. So if you take CD-ROM, it is only it is a VOM kind of thing. Write once and read many. Once if you write, you can use that for any number of times. Okay, as long as it is not physically damaged. There is another category of CD which is called as read-write disk, where you can write it, and then if you think the content is irrelevant, then you can erase it and then you can rewrite. Okay, so that's it about mass storage management. So what we have discussed, in the sense, the topic is storage management. Okay, so as a resource manager, operating system also performs storage management. Here, storage in the sense we refer to secondary storage devices like disks and tapes. This topic we are discussing under four headings: file system management, mass storage management, cache, and IO system. So first we define what is a file. So what is a file? The operating system abstracts from the physical properties of the storage devices and provides a logical storage unit for the user. This logical storage unit is called as file. Why operating system provides a logical storage unit? Because for the convenience of the user. Okay. And then we discuss that file is a collection of related information. The file can have a program or it may contain data, and there are different types of files like free form and strictly formatted file. Okay, files can also be organized into directories, and multiple files are placed in the memory. It may be so when multiple users have access to file, it may be desirable to control which user may access file and how they should be accessed. This will be controlled by the operating system. Okay, so this decision will be taken by operating system. So operating system, as a part of file management, it performs all these tasks. Okay, then we have discussed about storage management. Okay, so again, why we need storage? Because memory is main memory is volatile, so we need information to be stored permanently. For that, we need secondary storage devices like disks and tapes. And if these operate at a faster speed, obviously it will boost up the computer performance. And as a part of mass storage management, operating system performs these tasks. Sometimes if the mass storages are slower also, it will be useful. For example, for tertiary storage devices like optical storage or magnetic tape, even if it is slower, it is not going to affect the performance in any way. And these tertiary storage comes in two forms, either read-only format or read-write format. Read-only format is also called as WORM, W-O-R-M, write once and read many times. Okay, fine, thank you.